All right, and welcome back. Last we left off, we got the harrowing task of going to Cinnabar and getting some medicine for Jasmine. She can't get herself. What's in here? I think this is the Safari Zone. I mean, it looks like it has like a back opening. So we're gonna go to Cianwood and battle tower somewhere around here. Anyway, we go to Cianwood and get that medicine and also get battle the gym leader there. So let's get to it. This is the only substantial surfing route in this game. So that's good. I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one, but I'm not a fan of the surfing routes in Pokemon games. Like, if it was a straight up region where you can just walk, I would, you know, be okay with that. There's a bunch of tentacles. Hopefully we can go up and do something against them. Wasn't good, but it wasn't bad either. Much better. Should really give all the training I can to Pidgeotto. Pidgeotto should be first string. This is going to be a long route, since there's a bunch of nothing. And I want to battle all the trainers in the water first, before going to, Cianwood. I wonder why that Staryu's color is so flushed out. It's like it's been sitting in the sun or something. Once we can build on to a better move, I'm definitely evolving it. Of course I need to look up when that happens. Alright, let's see what a surf can do. Pretty sure it can do some massive damage. Ooh, a war turtle. You don't see those all every day. I don't know if we'll ever get to the Fabled region where we can actually catch starter Pokemon from any generation. Like, where do these Pokemon come from? Like, where's their natural habitat? Who knows? Thank you. Here's a theory with Generation 7. Was it Generation? Yeah, with the introduction of the Ultra Beasts. What if starter Pokemon are like different dimensional Pokemon? I could say that better. Pokemon from a different dimension that the professors are finding and just giving out. That's why you can never find any more of these creatures. Something to chew on right there. Chose to send in a Weeping Bell. Oh, cool. Six tentacles. Staryu in the bunch. Let's go with Pidgeotto. Not bad. To sweep the rest of these, rest of the last two Pokemon. Ooh, so close. No poison. Good. I'm gonna give this to Eevee. Eevee has not been as terrible as I had expected. Thought Eevee was going to be a drag on this team. But it's proven me wrong. So, surprised if it evolves now. Okay. Man, this is gonna be a long episode. Beat trainers and every nook and cranny. This is all sweet, sweet experience for Chuck. We all know, Pokemon. Pidgeotto definitely needs it. As do my other Pokemon, but... Ooh, Starmie. Might have to use Weeping Bell against Chuck's Poliwrath. Weeping Bell's really sprouting some legs here. any more trainers? Pretty sure there are. Somewhere around here. I am not. Eventually I'm going to have to catch a different water type Pokemon to actually use Whirlpool and Waterfall. But I wouldn't mind... I would actually. I was going to say I wouldn't mind Relegator having Waterfall, but it doesn't really matter in this generation. Waterfall and Surf are considered the same pretty much. But I think Surf is slightly stronger of a move. You know, with the advent of shark Pokemon, shark-inspired Pokemon, I'd be hesitant to just be swimming out in open water like this all the time. Really? Was the Resto Chesto a thing? Shaping up to be quite a training episode. Okay, so I'm gonna work some bark this time. A sea thing versus a alligator. Let's go. What is Gyarados anyway? Is it like some sort of lamprey or something? Like a mutant lamprey? I think that's the animal I'm thinking about. Let me Google it right quick. Close enough to a lamprey. Oh, another one, okay. That was the wrong Pokemon to send out. Should have went with Heracross. My mind is so programmed now that Gyarados has an intimidate and alluring attack stat. I'd be surprised if we both can pull out a win here. Alright, I'm not too worried about Woofenbell's being fainting. I think I already battled her. This will be the last person that I'm just gonna go to Cianwood and heal up. Are you supposed to battle Chuck first or Jasmine first? I've always just battled Chuck and then went back and battled Jasmine. Alright, let's see what, if we have anyone else up here. I think, yes, we do. The only water route, and they didn't hesitate. Just put all the trainers in this route. Give people something to do. Weeping Bell. Oh well. Let's go with Pidgeotto. One of these Pokemon battles can go a little bit faster. Alright, anybody else? Pretty sure I haven't battled you. Trusty Surf. Let's go with Eevee here. My Pokemon have yet to reach that threshold of being like incredibly trustworthy in a battle. Probably won't come about until we get to Price Mahogany Town. I think you get Fly and Cyanwood, which would be good. Fly back and get Fire Punch. I hope Heracross can learn Fire Punch. That would be such a help against Price. No, I definitely gotta heal up because I think Eevee's poisoned. I definitely don't want Eevee fainting. Anybody can learn any good moves, now would be the time. Look, I'm not crazy, right? Nobody seems to be learning any moves. Need a lot more, you know, bite. If you want to take on these stronger gym leaders now. Oh, we'll just keep Pidgeotto in. Some decent damage. Right now, we definitely need to heal up. Oh, cool, we're here. Okay, where is here? What the heck? Did that thing not just say that we were in Cyanwood? I certainly did say Route 41 again. Oh, I thought maybe fainted. Alright, I guess we should end the episode here. Now that we're in Cyanwood. We should battle Chuck after this. Yeah, that sounds like a good plan. Alright, thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.